Hi, Sharon.
Test.
Okay, no worries. Yep.
Just to let you know, Janet, that today we have the lovely Sophie and Gary. They're going to be your helpers. So if you need some help, you can call them.
Yep, sure.
They are very capable and competent, but lack initiative, so you need to give them feedback.
Okay. Yep.
Great. So, Janet, I'm going to give you a scenario and ask you to please repeat it back to me. All right. So, you've been called in to assess a gentleman who has got a 1 hour history of some chest pain that is radiating through to his left arm. He's a 58-year-old man and he's got a history of ischemic heart disease. He looks quite unwell and pale and sweaty. And I'd like you to please come and assess him and then allocate your time.
Sure. And what's his name, Sharon?
His name's George.
So George, 58-year-old male, who's got a one-hour history of central chest pain radiating down his left arm with the background of cardiac disease, and he's unwell and needs assessing?
Correct.
Sure. Quite diaphragmatic. Okay, so I walk into the room, I look for danger, and I'll just say, hi, George, how are you going?
Oh, hi, how are you?
Yeah, good, thanks. How are you feeling?
Oh, I've just got this really bad pain.
Okay, well, we'll have a look at that for you. So his airway's okay, he's talking to me. I might need to come back, but at the moment I'm happy. So I'm just going to have a listen to your chest. So what's his respiratory rate, Sharon?
He's got a respiratory rate of 16.
Okay, and I'll just auscultate his chest.
Chest is clear.
And palpate his trachea, is that midline?
It is midline.
And is he making much respiratory effort?
No, increased effort.
And I'll just pop a sat probe on his finger. Hopefully I've got one here. Okay. Just gonna pop this on your finger and check his sats. So sats are 97, so I think I'll leave oxygen for now. Okay, so gonna pop some monitoring on as well. I might pop the pads on at this stage to get a heart rate and also check his blood pressure. Can I get a blood pressure?
Yeah, so his blood pressure is
110. Okay. Just going to monitor your heart there. So I've got a blood pressure 110 on 60. Heart rate's 111. Looks okay, a bit tachycardic. Has he got a line in, Sharon?
He doesn't have any access.
No. I might get some help actually, because I'd like to get a 12 lead ECG as well. So I might call Sophie and Gareth. Just checking his cap refill.
Yeah, so cap refill time is 2 seconds.
Sorry?
Two seconds.
Hi, Sophie. So this is George. He's got some chest pain. He's got a history of cardiac disease. He's not feeling that well at the moment. Can you please put in a line and take some bloods and do a FBC, use the knees, and we'll do a CK and troponin and also check a blood sugar. And I might get Gareth. Where's Gareth? Can you get the ECG machine and do a 12 lead for me, Gareth? So circulation, I might move on to disability. So we'll check the blood sugar. And how are you feeling at the moment, George?
It's just this pain, it's really, really bad.
Okay, so we might need to give him some GTN for that. You said his blood pressure was 110? Okay, so we might just give you a tablet or spray under your tongue for your chest pain. Is he on aspirin?
He's not.
Okay, and he has, so we might also, Gareth, would you mind getting some aspirin ordered? Okay.
That drips in.
Great. Yep, okay. So so I'm on D, so he's an AVPU, he's an A at the moment, and we've checked his blood sugar. Is there any medication on his chart that's new or? Okay. So we'll just have a little look at him. Maybe, Gareth, if you can just have a look at his calves while we check there's no swelling, and we'll just check there's no bleeding anywhere or ovary signs.
Yep, so there's no signs of swelling or anything like that.
Okay.
Stop talking to you.
Okay, so we're just George, can you open your eyes?
So no response.
He's not responding. Is he making any respiratory effort?
So no chest rise.
Can't feel a pulse. Okay, Sophie, can you start CPR please? At 30 compressions, tube rest. Can you call a code, Gareth, and then manage the airway? Okay, actually, I might get you to put the pads on actually for me.
So pads are on.
Pads are on.
Yep.
Okay, so he's arrested. We've called for help. We've got CPR going. We'll do a rhythm check. I'm going to come down here.
Yep, so doing a rhythm check. So continue compressions. Oxygen's away. All clear, top, middle and bottom. Charging, 200 joules. Hands on.
So I'm going to, it's a shockable rhythm. Can you please shock it, Gareth? 200 joules.
Delivering a shock.
And we'll restart CPR, please. And we'll get some more help, hopefully, so that we can swap over regularly. So we're going to do 2 minutes of CPR, 30 compressions to two breaths. And if we've got someone on airway, we might put in a supraglottic device, because it will mean we can do continuous compressions. So establish resuscitation. Don't need to give any drugs. So we need to think about reversible causes. I think the most likely thing is thrombosis. So you might have had an AMI. Could have had a PE though, so they're my most likely causes. But thinking about toxins, you said he hadn't started on any new drugs. We don't think he's taken anything. Gareth, when we next do the breaths, can we have a quick listen to make sure that we've got equal air entry? So just trying to exclude attention in the thorax. I checked the trachea before.
It's midline.
So toxins, tension, cardiac tamponade. We might need to get an echo to determine that, and we can call for one of those so that we can check. And then we'll just go through the H's. So hypoxia, his sats were 97. You said he was a bit, maybe a bit short of breath, but... Sure, okay, so not too worried about that, and we're managing the airway. Is that going okay?
Yep,
so we're managing the airway. Don't think it's hypoxia. And we could do a blood gas now, so I can check his electrolytes. So I want to see what his K's doing.
So we'll send that off to the...
Yep, so it could be a hyperkalemia or other electrolyte disorders, and check his acidosis, his blood gas status as well. So hypovolemia. Hemorrhage, there's no signs of any bleeding or anything like that. And a temperature check, I forgot to do that before. Okay, so I think it's most likely it's coronary thrombosis, but we just need to... Sure, so can we do another rhythm check, please, Gareth?
Mm-hmm. Yep. So continue compressions, oxygen's away, all clear top, middle and bottom, charging 200 joules. Hands off.
So that's a shockable rhythm, Gareth. Can you deliver a shot, please? Okay, and we need to give 1 milligram of adrenaline, please, IV, and then continue CPR.
It's 1 milligram of adrenaline given.
We probably need a bit more help, but... So we've given 1 milligram of adrenaline, we're doing good CPR, we're managing the airway. I've sort of been through the reversible causes. I mean, we could give some fluid, but I'm not sure that it's really necessary, but we could maybe give 250 mils. It's probably not going to hurt. Okay, so can we do another rhythm check, please?
Okay, so compressions continue. Everyone else staying clear. I'm charging to 200 joules. Play top, middle and bottom.
So that's a shockable rhythm, Sophie. Can you shock that, please? So that's our third shock. So we also need to give amiodarone around 300 milligrams now. We'll give that over 3 minutes in 30 mils of dextrose and continue CPR.
Hey, amiodarone skin?
Yeah. Okay, so... So we're in BF, we think it's a thrombosis, we've gone through all the other reversible causes. Did we get the gas back?
Yeah, the cable's on.
So there's nothing really to change there. So we just need to keep doing effective CPR. And we gave adrenaline on the second shock, Sophie, so we can probably draw up another 1 milligram ready in case we need it at the next rhythm check. Sure. So, Sophie, can you do another rhythm check, please? And Gareth, once we've done the rhythm check, can you, unless we need to do something different, restart CPR straight away?
Okay, so compressions continue. Everyone else staying clear. I'm charging 200 joules. Top, middle, and bottom.
Hands
up. I'm set. So, it's VF. Can you shock, please, Sophie?
Okay, delivering shock.
Yep, and we commence CPR. Ideally, I'd like to swap, but we haven't got enough help. Okay, so we're continuing CPR.
2 minutes, Daddy.
Okay, can you please do another rhythm check, Sophie, and be ready to recommence CPR afterwards, Gareth, if need be.
Okay, so compressions continue. All else stand clear. Oxygen away. I'm charging 200 joules. Top, middle, and bottom.
So can you please disarm? It's a non-shockable rhythm. Gareth, can you please check a pulse?
Yep. For a pops.
We have a pops.
Okay, so that's good. So let's go into a reassessment stage now. So airway is still got the LMA in. Is he trying to wake up at all, Sharon?
He's tolerating it. He's having a few spontaneous breaths.
Okay. So let's get the sat prep. We've got sats of 96. So if you're happy to keep managing the airway and if you need supplementary breaths, please give them. But we've got a sat of 96. Sophie, can I get you to have another listen?
Yeah.
An auscultate. Yeah. So he's making respiratory effort. We've got good sats. Trachea probably hasn't moved since last time. So we move on to circulation and get a blood pressure, please. And he's got ST elevation there on the monitor. So let's get a 12 lead ECG and call cardiology. We probably could have done that earlier, but call them urgently. I think he might need to go to the cath lab potentially. So we've got blood pressure pulse, just recheck his cap refill. Yeah. And we'll just keep maintenance IV fluids. We won't fill him too much at the moment. So George, any eye opening?
He's a little bit on the cheek, but not.
So he's a V or a P? So he's a P or a U, sorry. He's a poo.
Yeah, it's
a bit of a P. Sure, okay. And we'll recheck the blood sugar and follow up the bloods. And then we'll just check we haven't caused any damage while we've been doing CPR. Can we please also organise a chest x-ray? And we'll probably start preparing to transfer him. So let's get all our emergency equipment set up. So we've got airway management drugs, the defib, oxygen, and get the team so that we can transport him to potentially cath lab, potentially ICU, depends on what cardiology say.
Thank you, Jana. We'll just stop you there.
Let's
get you out of that
fire for a moment. Sure. It's a bit nervous. Oh, thank God for that. Phew, that's a relief. Thanks.